that subscribe button if you want to look at daily Raw boxing content, guys. Now I had to make a video about this Wilder talking some of that, you know, S-H-I-T. Look at what Wilder had to say. Talking about Anthony Joshua. He's talking about the percentages in England and stuff like that. Bro, 70,000 people may look good in a small country, but you are not getting the money like you are over here just compared to 20,000. Damn, son. You make your money here in America. The mega boxing is here in America. It always will be, no matter what they are doing over there. And then the person writing the article writes, Wilder believes that a big knockout victory over Joshua would create a downward spiral in British boxing market. Oh, come on. All right. In British boxing market. In British boxing market, which has absolutely been booming in the last 2 years, with Joshua's rise playing a big role in that boom. Once I knock him out, all of that over there is going to go down and it will be no more. So choose your battles wisely. Choose your places wisely. Wherever he feels like it is going to be comfortable for him. If he has the courage to beat me, then so be it. I'll be there. I'll be waiting. Damn, son. So Wilder said a lot of interesting things here. Wilder hating, dude. He hating. So first of all, he's talking about that, you know, the thing that stood out to me the most was he said, once he KO'd Anthony Joshua, you know, like he's, I guess his popular, you know, I guess the British, the booming market in the British, like the, you know, there's a bunch of hype in British boxing, and Anthony Joshua is one of the main reasons why there's a lot of money in British boxing, because he's such a big draw, right? A lot of popularity going on over there. So I guess Wilder feels once he KOs him, that's going to stop. That's just going to disappear. And then he's talking about that, you know, Joshua has to, I guess he's saying he doesn't care where the fight happens, but he says Joshua, the money's all in America, and Joshua, man, I keep forgetting what I just read. I'm slow sometimes. I'm sorry, guys. And Joshua has to, what's his name? Be careful and be wise who he chooses to fight next. First of all, what I have to say is this. You know, if Joshua gets KO'd by Deontay Wilder, I don't think that his hype will disappear. I don't think that the British market will go downhill. Why would that happen? It's not like Joshua's the only person who's making, you know, the British. He is like the main front runner. But I would think that it would probably be the opposite. I would think that if he gets knocked out, because British boxing fans are very supportive of their fighters, they would want to see him again. I mean, look at when Kell Brook lost. His fans didn't give up. You know, when you looked at the stadium in Birmingham, whatever, when he fought in Sheffield against Errol Spence Jr., it wasn't like nobody came. People still supported him. I don't agree with... I understand where Wilder's coming from, first of all. Wilder keeps saying that, you know, America is the money. And I get what he's saying from that. You know, he probably sees guys like Mayweather, who's made, you know, $900 million in revenue and purse money, purse earnings in the United States. And he probably sees guys like Mike Tyson in the past, who's made, you know, he would make $30 million a fight. Mike Tyson and guys like Holyfield. But what Wilder has to realize is America is a massive place for boxing, right? And you do make a lot of money, but not in the heavyweight division. In the lower weight divisions, for example, like the welterweights, they make a lot of money. When Mayweather was fighting, he was making a lot of money. In America, the heavyweight division is just not that popular, like it used to be. 20 years ago, it was very popular. 20 years ago, the money was in the heavyweight division in America, because 20 years ago, guys like Mike Tyson, Evander Holyfield, these guys were making dough, and they didn't have to leave the United States because they were making. But again, that was 20 years ago. Right now, you know, ever since the Klitschko reign came along, the heavyweight division kind of died, especially like the Americans. Do you remember, like, for the longest time, there was no American heavyweights? Like, no good American heavyweights. We had guys like Calvin Brock, you know, Lamont Brewster, but there was no good American heavyweight. So I think that's why that kind of killed the fans' interest in the heavyweight division in America. If you get what I'm saying, I think it kind of killed. It kind of like killed it for a minute. And now Wilder is coming along, guys like Joe Romero, but it's still not big like it used to be. And Wilder never became that. He never stole the hearts of the American people. I guess I don't know. But the bottom line is when he fights Joshua, he has to go to England and he has to knock him out in England. And then he'll be, it'll help him out dramatically because, first of all, he'll get that massive payday, he'll get all the belts, and he'll knock him out in front of like 90,000 people. So all those 90,000 people are going to know who, if they didn't know who Deontay Wilder was, oh, trust me, they're going to know who he was. And they're going to know who he is for the rest of their lives. They're going to be like, man, that's the guy that knocked out Anthony Joshua in front of 90,000 people. I'm telling you, they're going to be saying 20 years from now, I remember I went to that fight and I was there in the stadium and I saw in Wembley and I saw, you know, Joshua get knocked out for the first time in his career. So he's going to have to go to England. Like I said, I don't think Joshua losing the fight to losing a professional fight is going to necessarily ruin his career or have the British, you know, the British fans like lose interest in boxing, because everybody loses. That's like saying if an American who's undefeated loses, all of a sudden boxing in America is dead. Or if a guy from the Ukraine, if he's undefeated and he loses, all of a sudden the boxing in the Ukraine is dead or something. Many British fighters have lost, and they didn't stop you know, Britain from loving boxing and supporting the boxers. So I don't think that's the case. I actually think it might be opposite. I think if Wilder were to lose, I think it'll be worse for him, because Joshua has tested himself. So even if he were to lose, because he has a massive fan base already, and because he's tested himself, even if he were to lose, people will still give him respect. They'll be like, okay, he lost to Wilder. Or if he lost to another guy, not just Wilder, another guy, you know, they'll be like, okay, but he was a proven fighter. But when it comes to Wilder, if he were to get knocked out by Joshua, because he's been cherry-picking his entire career, the minute he gets knocked out, oh my God, like, this guy's going to get crucified. I'm telling you right now, the British boxing fans, they'll go all over social media. I'm telling you right now, if Anthony Joshua were to knock out Deontay Wilder, the British boxing fans will be going ham on him. Like, they'll be on all over social media, on Twitter, on his Instagram. Like, he'll be receiving hate on, especially on YouTube. Because you know how subscribers are. They'll be leaving our comments dissing fighters. He'll be getting crucified, Deontay Wilder. So, I think it's actually worse for him. Joshua, because he's actually stepped his level of competition and actually fought legit guys, I think they'll be easier. Like, the boxing public will be more easier on him, even if he loses. They'll be disappointed, I guess, depending on the fashion he loses. But they'll probably still be easier on him. It's kind of like Terrence Crawford. If Terrence Crawford were to lose right now, do you think the boxing public will be shitting all over him? Let's say he were to fight Errol Spence Jr. and lose to Errol Spence Jr. You think the boxing public will be shitting all over him? No. Some, you know, obviously some trolls might be doing that. But the majority of boxing fans will be like, look, he was the undisputed champion at 140, and he attempted to move up to 147 and face a young, hungry gun. And he came up short. He lost to Errol Spence Jr. But the point is, he was already a proven fighter, right? He already proved that he was a legit fighter by wiping out the 140-pound division. And he challenged himself. He challenged himself against a bigger man like Errol Spence Jr. And he came up short and lost. So I don't think the boxing public would be too harsh on someone like Terrence Crawford. It's kind of like Kell Brook. When Kell Brook lost to Gennady Golovkin, that was his first professional loss, right? But if you notice, the boxing public wasn't too harsh on him. Only people who maybe don't like Kell Brook, but the majority of the boxing public weren't too harsh on him because they recognized that he was a smaller guy moving up in weight, right? So, but when it comes to someone like Deontay Wilder, that's how I feel they'll react to someone like Terrence Crawford. If he came up short to like Errol Spence, let's just say, right? But like I said, when it comes to someone like Deontay Wilder, he's not testing himself. So he's already created this bad stigma around him because he's been cherry picking for like 10 years. So because he's been cherry picking for 10 years, he's created this bad, you know, aura around him that they look at him, that people perceive him as a cherry picker. So if he were to lose to a legit guy, people would just, you know, they will not be nice. They will not be, you know, nice to Wilder. They will be going ham on Wilder. They will be, you know, crucifying Wilder because of his own choices of opponents. But like I said, if he was let's say he had a stacked record. Let's say Wilder was actually challenging himself for 10 years and he had a stacked record. And then he were to lose. People will still clown him, but people will still show him respect because they'll be like, okay, at least he tested himself. At least we could tell he's legit, you know? So, yeah, it's kind of like, look at when Vladimir Klitschko. When Vladimir Klitschko got lost to Anthony Joshua, did they shit on Vladimir Klitschko? No. People were applauding Vladimir Klitschko. Why? Because Vladimir Klitschko had a stacked resume, right? Vladimir Klitschko was a long-running champion. So, I don't remember people shitting on Vladimir Klitschko. People saying, I told you Vladimir Klitschko was a hype job, because everybody recognized that Vladimir Klitschko wasn't a hype job, right? He was a legit contender for 10 years, right? So, that's what it is with Wilder. Because he has such a, you know, shit resume, when he loses, he's going to be shitted on, and he's going to be crucified, and he might just retire. But I don't think we should feel too bad for him, because when he fights Anthony Joshua, he's going to make the most money of his career. So even if he does get exposed, quote unquote exposed against Joshua, and even if he does lose against Joshua, guess what? He would have made, I don't know, maybe $15 million. But like I said, if Wilder at this point in his career wants to have people respect him, wants the American boxing fans, the British, especially the British boxing public, because the British boxing public do not respect Wilder, right? If he wants them to respect him, he has to knock out Joshua in front of 90,000 people. Because imagine if he does that. He going into that ring, they're going to be booing him. And then imagine if he knocks him out, Joshua, in front of 90,000 people. That's going to send a big message right there to become the unified champion. Obviously, this all has to play a part. Joshua has to beat Parker. We don't know. That's not a foregone conclusion. We have to wait to see what happens there. But still, that's just my thoughts on this whole thing. Let me know what you guys think of this Wilder's thoughts. And I'm out. Thanks for watching, guys.